Assalamu alaikum boys. Today we will start our work on neat copies, that how you will do your work on the neat copies. So first of all, divide your notebook into English A and English B portion. Leave 3 pages for course content and your handwriting pattern, and then start your work for unit 1, Pika Pika, page number 4. Okay, so you will prepare your title page for unit 1 like this. This is the way you will prepare your title page, and then from the next page you will start your work. In the previous lectures, we have discussed these word meaning from unit 1. You will give headings in the capital, you will draw a line in the center, ending line should be a complete ending line. You will give 1 finger space after each word, and the first alphabet should be small. Aggressive means angry, ready to attack. Untidy means messy. Chattering means gossiping, talking. Fed up means tired or exhausted. Steel means to rot. This is the way you will do your words meaning. After doing your words meaning on English A side, on the next page you will prepare a page for your word sentence. Again, capital, headings, line, and then first word is mirrored. I have done some sentences for you here. You can make your sentences by your own. I bought a mirror from the market. My friend gifted me a mirror. Fight. I do not like to fight. Please don't fight with me. Spoke. He spoke politely. My friend spoke politely. Nest. Magpies make untidy nest. Clever. Ali is a clever boy. So this is how you will do your sentences. After each sentence, skip a line and draw a complete ending line at the end. Okay boys, so you have done your title page, word meaning and word sentence. The next thing that you will do is your comprehension passage. So I have taken this passage from your page number 4. The unit is Pika Pika. So you can write this paragraph in dotted form. After that, I have done question number 1 for you, that how you will attempt all of these questions. Now look at question number 1. Who was teaching the birds to make nest? Now make sure that if the tense here is past tense, then your answer should also be in the past tense. If the tense is present, then answer should also be in the present tense. Who was teaching the birds to make nest? Now you have to read your page number 4, and then you will get the answer, that the wise old owl was teaching the birds to make nest. So you have written the question, then you write the answer, leave 1 line, draw an ending line, then you will move towards your question number 2. Look at question number 2. The clever, confident magpie. The clever, confident magpie. What are the adjectives here? Now you all should know, what do you mean by an adjective? An adjective is a word that describes a noun. So what is the noun in this sentence? Magpie. Magpie is your noun. So you will write that the, who is explaining magpie? Clever and confident. So you will write the adjectives here are clever and confident. These clever and confident, they are describing magpie. That magpie is clever and confident. So these two words are your adjectives. What is the meaning of except? Again, after completing question number 2, you will draw an ending line. Then you will do question number 3. What is the meaning of except? The meaning of except is other than. What kind of nest does magpie produce? Now you all know that magpies make untidy or messy nest. So here the tense is present tense. So you will do like magpie makes, produces. You will write an S here. Produces untidy or messy nest. Understand? Then again completing it, drawing an ending line. Question number 5. Write the past participle of spoke. Now you all should know that past participle means third form of verb. Past participle means third form of verb. So the third form of spoke is spoken. So you will write the past participle of spoke is spoken. You will do all this work. You will do these 5 question answers in your neat copy and draw an ending line at the end. First you will prepare the title page, then you will do words meaning, then sentences, then your comprehension passage on English A side. Okay, on page number 6, we have discussed exercise A, B and C with all of you, that how you will do that exercise A, B and C in your neat copies. Okay, this is with your unit 1. You will prepare your page like unit 1, grammar, heading, then exercise A, then again you will do exercise B and C. You will write the question, then you will write the statement, first the incorrect statement, and in the next line you will write the correct statement. Understand? Okay boys, so you will do it like this, exercise A, B and C from page number 6. This is your page number 6, grammar exercises. This is your exercise A. Then you will do your exercise B. We have already discussed this. And then you have to do your exercise C. You will write this paragraph and then you will rewrite it correctly. The same way we have discussed it, that this paragraph is about solar system and the planet Earth and all other planets. So you all should know that the beginning of a sentence is always capital. The ending has a full stop. If there is a specific name, just like the planets we have, then you will write the starting of those planets with a capital. So starting capital, you certainly know that the moon revolves around the Earth, E capital, and is therefore the Earth, I small, Earth, E capital. Then this is beginning of a sentence, so B capital. Did you know the sum of the other planets have their moons, full stop. O capital, out of the 9 planets in the solar system, Mercury. See, now Mercury, Venus and Pluto, alphabets capital, have no satellite. Then full stop, beginning of a sentence, so T capital. The other 6 planets have 31 satellites between them. Beginning of a sentence, and also Jupiter, J capital, is the largest planet and it has the most satellites. Full stop, I capital, it has 12, comma, Saturn, Uranus, Mars and Neptune, N, M, U and S capital. Then again you have to put commas here. Understand? Then to each. Full stop, beginning of a sentence, the Earth, E capital, is the only planet that has a single satellite, the moon. So this is the title of the moon. So T and M capital, then a full stop. This is the way you will do this exercise A, B and C in your neat copies. Next, we have already discussed page number 7 word study, that you will do exercise A, B, C and E on your books with a pencil, and exercise D is not included. Today we also discussed checkup exercises on page number 8. We have done exercise A, B and C, and you will do it on your books with a pencil. Now look at exercise A. Here you are given certain words and you have to fill in these blocks. Now zebra has stripes, birds have beak, tortoise has a shell, dog have paws, cow have udders, dolphin has a bottlenose, cat has whiskers, whale has blubber, salmon has scales and elephant has a tusk. So these are the specialities or certain characteristics of these animals. So you will write it like this in your on your book with a pencil. Next, these are simple true or false. For true you will put a tick and for false you will put a cross. Magpies are clever birds. Yes, they are. A fable is a true story. No, it's not a true story. Magpies are gentle birds. Magpies are gentle birds. Cross. Magpies have very untidy nest. Yes, true. Magpies are thieves. Yes, they steal. Magpies build their nest quickly. Cross. Magpies do not recognize themselves in mirror. Cross. Fables often include talking animals. True. The wise old owl build all the nest. Cross. Fables are only for adults. See, it's very simple. You can do it on your books. Okay, boys. The last exercise that we did on page number 8 today was this using capital letters and full stop. So, it's very easy. See, the starting of the sentence is capital and full stop. And if you have a specific name like London, Treasure Island, August, Dubai and Friday, then alphabets will be capital. You will do it here and then you will rewrite the sentences in the correct manner. So you have to do these checkup exercises on your books. This word study exercises will be also on your books. You have to do grammar exercises in your neat copies along with your words meaning, sentences, comprehension passage, okay, and title page. Okay boys, I hope you all understood today's work. Please take your April-May task if you have not taken. So come to school and take it from your school office and do it in your neat copies at the back of your English B side. Okay, thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.